generates around 30% of the company's sales, and he is also our leader in Bangkok. So he's the leading the team in Bangkok. We have a big team in Bangkok also, and so he basically 2 weeks of every month he's in Thailand now. Yeah. So we'll hear his story as the last person. Let's give him a big round of applause. They walk with you.
Hello everyone.
Hi.
My name is Irvine and I'm a leader in Aphrozone. Thank you, Johan, for this opportunity. Okay, so I think I'll begin a bit of my story before I started Rubycell. How am I and where do I come from? Okay. So I'm actually 20 this year. Okay. Last year when I started the business, I was 19. And before that, when I was 15, my parents separated. Okay, my mom went to Australia and my dad is in Malaysia. But at the same year, my dad got stroke. So suddenly the finance went really bad. We have nothing, completely broke. So for that 2 years, I eat Maggi Mee. Do you guys know Maggi Mee?
Yeah. Yes.
For 2 years, I eat Maggi Mee. Now I see Maggi Mee, I cry. I don't want anymore. Yeah, so for the 2 years I eat Maggi Mee, because that time when I was 15, I cannot go to work because I went to for a few jobs. It's illegal. They say you are too young, you cannot work now. So okay, then I continue study. So when I finished study, 17 years old, I came out to do sales. So in the sales company, I did really well. I made quite a lot of money. So after 2 years, which is 18, then I see all my friends, they go to college. So you also want that kind of life, right? You also want to join your friends, to go to party, go to college, all this life. So eventually, I want that life also. So I went to college. I took out the money I earned in sales. I paid for the college, for the registration, first time payment and everything. It's around 5K. So after 5K, then my bank don't have much money anymore. So I need to drive to school, I need to pay parking ticket, I need to pay all these things. So it costs a lot actually, it's not that cheap to go to college. So then I started realizing that I have not enough money anymore. So I start to look for something to do and I stopped the college. I told the person that I'm not gonna study anymore. You hold on to my registration, I'm gonna come back when I have money. So they hold the money and I went to look for a job. So I went to this job as a barista. You guys know barista? You learn how to make coffee, all this thing. Why did I choose barista is because, you know, when people make coffee with a love shape, they look very good, right? Yeah, that's why I want to do that. So I went there, but they only pay 6 ringgit per hour. So it's very less. I couldn't survive that much when I worked there. But because I want to learn how to make coffee, that's why I was there. So after a few weeks, then I met this guy who is very fierce. Looking guy, wearing full black, came up to me. So in the street there, I was like, oh, very scary, this guy. I look like this, then I walk past him. Then he said, hey bro, he called me. Then I say, oh, actually we are in a business class. That's where we met. So after the class, his car got problem. So he asked me to pick him up, to send him to the workshop. So in the drive, right, he asked me, what are you doing now? So I say, oh, a barista. He said, oh. Then he asked me this question, where do you see yourself in 5 years? So I stand for, well, the world, what I'm gonna do, I also don't know. Wake up, I don't know what to do also. He asked me about 5 years already. So very serious question, you know, I need to think for a while. So the whole 5 minutes, I'm just thinking, driving, thinking. Then he asked me, then I tell him, I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna become in 5 years. So he said, oh, you're gonna become the best barista in the world. Then I was like, wow, sounds pretty good, you know? Can become the best barista in the world. So I wanted to become the best barista in the world. Then he said, if you put the same effort in and you can make more money, would you like to join? So I said, oh, sounds interesting, because at that time, I just need more money. I don't care whatever it is, you know? So I said, okay, why not? Then I went to the company, which is in Solaris. I sit down with him for 1 week. And 1 week, he did not even tell me anything about Rubycell. You just tell me about life. And I was like, wait, bro, I want to make money and you tell me about life so much for what? I cannot make money about life, bro. Then okay, then that's how I started the business. So then I keep following, keep talking me about life. Then throughout this 1 year, actually before 1 year when I started, I looked 2 times smaller. But after today, I look 2 times bigger. Why? It's because now that I'm able to buy what I want, eat what I want, and actually my dream is to eat whatever I want. I really like to eat, to be honest. So throughout this 1 year, I achieved that. And I even achieved to give my parents money rather than they giving me money. Even though I'm so young, but I give them money because I think this is my responsibility to do for them now. And yeah. So even though my life is like this, if I give up, I wouldn't be here today and I wouldn't make the things I want to do today, buy the things I want to do today. So before I close, I end my speech, I'm gonna say that your life is you are 100% responsible of your life. Thank you so much.